just found our new favorite pub in Australia. I know that's quite a thing to say. And hey, it might change as we continue traveling around, but this is now our favorite one. Let me show you. Come with me. There's Brad waiting for lunch. I was just telling them about how this is our new favorite pub in Australia.
Cheers. Yes, this is definitely our new favorite pub in all of Australia. Silverton held it for quite a number of years, 2 or 3. But now we've found one that's going to surpass it. Sorry, Silverton.
So what is it about this pub that you like, Brad? For starters,
cold beer.
Pints.
And that aside, the prices for the food here aren't bad. I don't know what the portion sizes are like, but I guess here's good things. The pub just has everything that you're looking for. A cool out back, music, a little bit of everything.
And a little bit of every traveler that's left, that's wanted to leave its mark on the pub as well.
Yeah, and it has a really good atmosphere. A lot more people seem to be passing through here. It's only 11:30, 12 o'clock, and there's caravans all the way down the street.
Can you lift it? Show me the inside.
Pretty healthy portions.
That's a good chunk of barra.
We're not too far from the ocean now, so it's safe to eat fish.
And they're actually also famous here for their barra.
Let's dig into it, find out.
And then you can go, mmm.
Mmm.
So, verdict. I mean, we already told you that we loved it. The food is fantastic. The atmosphere is great. I'd love to come back when they've got some live music going on that stage, because that stage looked really badass. All in all, it's just a wonderful stop. The heat is here. The pool looks nice and cold. The beer is cold. We got a few different options on tap and not to buy in bottles like we had at the pubs on the Unidata track, which was fine, but it's not the same, you know? It's just not the same. Yeah, all in all, just a really rockin' outback pub. Definitely the first place pub on my list. So the pub is famous for having Northern Territory's oldest pub. So they claim that they're Northern Territory's oldest pub. I don't know anyone else that's claimed that. I've seen most central pub, and I've seen first and last pub in the Northern Territory, now oldest. Everyone's got a claim to fame somehow. They find their angle. Even if it's just like in the Southern Hemisphere, or like oldest windmill of this style still running.
In the Southern Hemisphere.
But you'll see that across Australia, and you probably noticed that in our videos and stuff, that we always pinpoint these things because it's still interesting. Like, everyone should have their opportunity to have their claim at fame.
And there is no shortage of visitors here. Whilst we sat down for just a beer and a burger, we probably counted 6 or 7 caravans that just came rolling in, and it's not even midday yet.
Honestly, like, in a 1 minute period, I counted 6 massive caravans and 1 camper van that came through, and that was on top of the people that were already at the pub. Sergeant's allowed to go. He's not allowed to go anywhere else. Just the car park. We've never been north of Alice Springs, so it's pretty exciting. And I really wanted to put this place on the list, but it's actually like 400 kilometers almost north of Alice, like 300-400 kilometers. So it wasn't worth it on our first trip, but now that we're headed to Darwin, it was definitely worth stopping over. They've got 4 walks here. They're all relatively short. There's one lookout. And then there is a campground area here, but we can't camp there because we've got the dog. So it is what it is, and you know, some people might see that as a hindrance to their trip, but you know what? I'm sure it's gonna be a lot busier than some of the other areas that we camp. It's actually pretty interesting being here. Now, I don't know why, maybe it's just because of the images that I've seen on social media, but I kind of didn't expect quite so many rocks to be here. Like, when they said Devil's Marbles, I'm pretty sure I've only seen, like, photos of two rocks online, like, together, kind of like they're almost look like they're split in half, balancing all really cool. But there's heaps of different rocks and stuff out here. It's amazing how round some of these are, and how others are just a completely different shape. Or how when you look at them from a distance, they look really round, but you get up to them and they're just these like weird shapes instead. Makes for quite the nice walk. Something a little bit different in the desert.
Thank you.